On Sunday, January 14th, 2018, Holly Hamilton was agitated. This is according to her older sister, Stacy, who took the stand in court today. Stacy says Holly was being bombarded with texts and calls from her ex and the father of her child, Justin Dumpfrey. The man wanted to see his child, Stacy told the court, but she said Holly knew it was just another one of his manipulation tactics. In an agreed statement of facts, the Crown read out a history of domestic violence committed by Dumpfrey in the past, including an incident in 2014 where Dumpfrey pled guilty to assaulting Hamilton while she was 3 months pregnant. And another incident in 2016 where Dumpfrey also pled guilty to assaulting Hamilton, hitting her several times in the head in front of their child. That Sunday night in January, Holly would tell Stacy, who she lived with, that she and her child were going to visit a friend. It would be the last time Stacy would see her sister alive. Stacy Hamilton told the court that the next morning, January 15th, Holly and her child still hadn't returned home, and that's when she began to worry. That evening, Stacy would go to Holly's mother's house and they would call the police. While she was there, Stacy says there was a knock on the door. The child had been returned by Dumpfrey, but he just took off. Stacy said the child was terrified. Family members began asking where her mother was and if Holly was hurt. Days later, Holly Hamilton's body would be found in the trunk of her work car that was in an underground parking garage on Barton Street. The Crown told the jury today that Hamilton's body was frozen and was found with 17 stab wounds to the face, neck, and torso. The Crown told the jury that Hamilton's child told police what happened. She and Mommy left to go see Daddy at his house. Mommy and Daddy were smoking in the bathroom. She saw Mommy sleeping in the tub, but the water wasn't on. She told Mommy, "I love you," but Mommy didn't answer because she didn't hear. She was sleeping. The trial continues tomorrow. Kelly Botelho, CHCH News.